with the money. I'm Carl Lewis, really running the best. Car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed. Car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed. I'm really just running for money. I'm Love Flow Joe chasing the check. I'm really gonna run up the money. I'm Carl Lewis, really running the best. Car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed. Car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed.
Like a secretary, boy, I'm legendary. When I'm dead and buried, still be kicking flavor in the cemetery. Trap music originator, fresh off of my hiatus. Yelling, you to all my haters. They skywalk, I'm Darth Vader. But promise I don't give a about them little mountain anywhere till a million out of them. Yep, like in the Kango Anna. New Cadillac with some all gold hammer. Long as I remember how to Atlanta. I can give a about a dog. Used to getting things from a chat, so I count setting numbers in the hood. Do what I say, do test. Break bread, a fake dead, a bit to hate that. 50 million, you die to make that. Middle.
All right, Coach, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the so-called Silicon Valley and Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Arizona Cardinals and the San Francisco 49ers. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Carry now. This is Johnson. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down.
You can script and diagram plays all you want, but no one really envisions something like that happening this early in the game. How about that run to get things started? Didn't he win NFC Player of the Week last week?
Yeah, he was on fire a week ago, and what a start to this one.
Yeah, no sign of him cooling down at all.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They go play action here on first down. This one complete to Christian Kirk. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards. One's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. A good chance. This is four down territory if they're unable to convert. But right now looking at a third and three. Here's Rosen to throw. And throw here, that's complete. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. First catch for him. It's good for a dozen and a first down. Six there as he takes this one down to the 24-yard line.
All right, Brad, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
Rosen looking. Jeffrey with a catch left side. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. That good for six as they keep this drive right on rolling. How about the start throwing the football? 4 for 4 on this opening drive.
Oh, he's slinging it. And oftentimes when you talk about slinging it, you're thinking about a guy throwing it all over the yard, not necessarily accurately. In this case, though, he's honing in on his targets, and he's delivering.
Yeah, the opening script, however, they drew it up for this first drive, going to plan so far. And he's going to be wrapped up and driven down. Reuben Foster in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year. You know, last week it was unbelievable how many times they were in the backfield. They had 7 sacks. Whatever they had for pregame meal last week, maybe they had it again.
I think they're going to continue to repeat it if they keep this up. But remember, we were at their facility. And we walked past the defensive meeting room, and what did it say over the door? Rush the passer.
And he's going to go down again. Jordan Jenkins in there to get him. And this pass rush strong now. That sack's on back-to-back plays. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Now Rosen. Johnson's got it complete. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
His passing's been on point on this drive, hasn't it? Been very accurate, gotten the ball downfield, gained nice chunks of yardage. But now, in this situation, the field is really condensed, partner. So if he's going to throw the football, that has to be pinpoint here.
I was going to ask you about that. Field shrinks, has to be sharper, but it's been a good opening drive so far.
Now they just want to see if they can cap it off with the bell ringer and put it in the end zone.
It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal.
Gun! Watch it now, Barney!
He'll get it up the middle. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, but now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this 4-down territory? Might he go for it?
To throw is Rosen, and he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Christian Kirk, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Cardinals take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Carlson now to kick this one away. This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll They'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their own 26. Garoppolo now, first down throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. No gain on the play there. It'll be second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. Throwing now is Garoppolo. And the grab by Croft. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up the touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now, or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get down, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series.
They stop them for only 3 that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Well, we hear so often how tackling has become almost a lost art in the NFL game, but it's so important to tackle well on these receivers, especially in a play like this one. Third down, they gave him the underneath stuff. You got to go up and make the tackle right away.
So on now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away. He was called on 3 times in the win last week as his first one here's away. Taking it about the 16. 12 yards on the return that time. And the Cards will take over, first and 10. The Cardinals offense now works their way back onto the field. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. I mean, look, they're on the road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up 2 touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. It'd be ideal.
Rosen and the Cardinals take over with a first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. They begin the drive with Johnson. They'll only get a couple up to about the 30.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Gone. On second down, here's Rosen. The 49ers get there. Solomon Thomas in there to bring him down, and that is sack number 17 for him now on the year. The Cardinals on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This will be third and 15. From the shotgun, it's Rosen. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. It'll be a pickup of 14, but they're still a little bit short as it brings up fourth. And he is the NFC reigning offensive player of the week. You got to think, all the guys that take the field each and every week, that's not an easy award. Always has to feel good to grab it.
It has to feel great because it separates you, at least for a week, amongst your peers. And for him to separate again, he has to have the same type of a game. That means being explosive off the line of scrimmage and catching everything that comes his way.
A very good return there. Give him an even 20 yards. And the Niners will go on offense, first and 10. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now, what you're looking for is, can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
Yeah, they'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Now a play fake. Garoppolo. There's the Washington Husky. It's Dante Pettis. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A good pickup there of 22. First and 10. Oh, he can't hang on. That was a dream chance for any D lineman to possibly get a pick. But instead, it falls down incomplete. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. His way forward for about four up to the midfield stripe.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Sends this one away. That's fielded at the 8-yard line. Well, it wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And out will come the offense as they take over. So out now come the Cardinals. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a pressure
from his right, and he goes down hard, flat on his back.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
To go here in the first half. Back to more NFL action on EA Sports after this. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Out of the gun, here's Josh Rosen. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down. The Cardinals on third down, they've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This is third and 4. From the gun, it's Rosen. And he finds Seals Jones complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. And they pick up 25 as they convert on third. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. On first down, it's Rosen. Throw right side is going to be caught by Kirk. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
Detroit!
This quarterback
Detroit!
Now, 10 of 10 to start the game. How about that? As he comes up on a first and 10. Rosen to throw again. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
All right, now, Lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Now Rosen to throw on second down. And that is incomplete.
But one thing's for sure, when you've got a big receiver and you trust him downfield, you're going to give him opportunities to go up and get that 50-50 ball.
And he is a darn good big receiver. Unfortunately, that time didn't work out. Nice job defensively. The Cardinals on third down, they've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. This is third and 17. And looking to throw. He's going to fire one deep, middle, and at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one. Try and run. This is Johnson. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. Rosen will throw. Under pressure now, and he's going to go down. Sack back around the 8. Mario Edwards. Now a timeout. 7 seconds left in the first half. In there to drop him for his 5th sack of the year. So on third down, the field goal unit will come out as he'll try to get 3 before half. This from 25 yards out. Carlson able to put this one through. And the lead moves to 10-0. So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, and the net result, 3 points.
Take your disappointment and put it aside. 9 plays, yeah, they want to end up in the end zone with a touchdown. I get that. But sometimes those 9-play drives pay dividends later with another 9-play drive that culminates in a touchdown when they wear down a defense.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. We now proceed to the start of the second half. So we have reached halftime with the visiting Cardinals out in front. Here comes the 49ers offensive unit as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
180! 180! Watch 85! Ball going 85! Watch 85! Omaha.
The drive starts with a handoff to McKinnon. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. Give the tackle to Hassan Reddick.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
Here again is McKinnon, and he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32. Good job there keeping him to a short gain. Of course, he's coming off a really terrific performance, reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week.
And I know people get caught up in, well, if you're the reigning Defensive Player of the Week, you must have made a bunch of spectacular plays. Like, you mixed in a few of those, but most of the plays are just like we saw there. Keep them to short gains, make the fundamental tackle.
Garoppolo, nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
On plays like this, where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
It'll be a 47-yard punt with a net of 40 following a 7-yard return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Rosen and the Cardinals take over with a first and 10 at their 36-yard line. And they'll start the drive on the ground with Johnson. And the hole closes quickly there. He gets maybe a couple up to the 38.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
Again, it's Johnson. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd-and-9 situation. The Cardinals on 3rd down. They have been superb. 5 for 6 to this point. This is 3rd-and-9.
Detroit!
Here's Rosen. Kirk complete, and he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. And 21 yards there as they convert on 3rd.
Detroit! 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 Detroit!
Play action here with Rosen. He's going to fire one deep, and this is taken in at the 5. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. And give him a gain of 37. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's 1st and goal. It's Rosen. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cardinals. As his guys are in for 6, and the Cardinals will extend their lead. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit. Get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, you know, the second half, no matter what, whether it's first 5 minutes, first 3, whatever, this was a big score to start the second half.
Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Garoppolo on 1st down. The Cards get to him here. He's brought down for a sack.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
Got to imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on 2nd down following the sack. It's 2nd and 18.
Here we go. 180.
A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line.
So, Brandon, we've sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
On third and long, it's Garoppolo. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Another drive comes and goes, still nothing on the scoreboard.
Yeah, and when the second half comes, you know, it's real easy to get discouraged and wonder if you're ever going to get things started. You just got to fight through it. Got to keep pounding away.
He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. Taken right around the 44. A 46-yard punt, 4-yard return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field.
This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
It's still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
The opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Now a 10th carry for Johnson. And he stopped immediately there. And the tackle there will go to Ryan Anderson. Now they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
The Cardinals on third down. They've been excellent, 6-for-7. This is third down and 12. Here's Rosen to throw. And that is incomplete. And give credit to Reuben Foster, the linebacker, getting a hand in to disrupt. Something we haven't really seen much of from him, an incomplete pass.
Yeah, last week he finished at 70%. This week he's up over 80%. I don't know how you slow him down. Pass rush is usually the best way, because a quarterback on his back usually can't complete a pass.
The 49ers offense making its way back out there. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
And the first play of the drive goes to McKinnon. And he goes nowhere. He'll lose yardage back at the 17. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Second down, here's Garoppolo. He's going to air one out, and he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Trying to get it to Willie Snead there, and it's third down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion, and to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
And this is going to be incomplete.
Well, this at least is the right idea. I think they've got to get the tight end more involved.
He had just one target in the first half, incomplete. Now incomplete here with the first target in the second half.
Yeah, should not stop them at all from going back to him. Find him. Find him.
Fielded at the 33. A great return there of 22 yards.
And the Cardinals, great field position to start this drive as they take over first and 10. The Cardinal offense now making their way back out onto the field.
This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
And he's going to be met at about the 43. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
On second down, Rosen. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. Back now here in Santa Clara. It's Cardinal football. They're also out in front of the scoreboard as we get set for the fourth. The Cardinals on third down. They've hit on 6 of their 8 tries. Very good. This will be third and a mile. Rosen off the play action. He's going to wind up and air it out. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. Adrian Colbert, he was right there in coverage.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
That'll go for only 17 yards on the punt. The 49er offense now making their way out onto the field.
And right now these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because 3 straight drives have ended with them punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive.
Throwing on first is Garoppolo. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
Garoppolo to throw on second down. And he will not get the connection there. It's incomplete. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
The Niners on third down. Not good. 0 for 4 thus far. This will be third and 6. From the gun, it's Garoppolo. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. There he goes, left side. Touchdown, 49ers. Jerick McKinnon, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the 49ers get a score closer. Well, he's used to running it that distance. Here he had to catch it, too, before making the run. Heck of a play for the score.
There's not many things better for an offense than a back who is a complete guy who can run it and catch it. And we just saw him complete a big-time play for a touchdown.
The punter, Pinion, now to kick this one away. And the Cardinals getting set to trot out there now.
Certainly want to avoid what they had to do last possession. That was punt the football, because this game's starting to tighten up.
In a basketball sense, you think about taking a little bit of the air out of the ball, right? Maybe milk some clock, limit the possessions. In this case, they might want to do the same thing, but control the game offensively. Put together some first downs, put together a drive,
Detroit!
And keep it
Detroit!
Away from them.
Rosen and the Cardinals take over with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Johnson, and he'll get this one up to the 26. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the top plays that these guys like to run. The best runs for the top running back, those are the ones you focus on and want to take away. And they've done that pretty successfully in this game.
They go to Johnson again. Johnson with a burst, a first down and more, as they finally wrangle him in at the 48. That good for 22 and a first down.
Well, that looked like an example of what you said back in the first half. A running back of his size can really wear down a defense. I think he's starting to do that.
I think you're exactly right. And know what else he's doing? He's inspiring the rest of his team because they see this starting to happen as well. So that means they're going to redouble their efforts to help him out. Extra blocking, getting downfield, helping him out.
Now Johnson. And he's going to be brought down inside the 45 at the 43.
Now I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Stop before he could even get started.
It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down. The Cardinals on third down. 6 conversions and 9 tries. They've done a great job of picking these up. This is 3rd and 4.
To throw is Rosen. Dumping it off for Johnson. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and it'll be 4th down. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. You like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion, and what you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
Down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback.
The San Francisco offense getting their last minute instructions before they take over here.
And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Garoppolo now, first down throw. Caught by Snead over the middle. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. A good start there on this fourth quarter drive. They need more of what we just saw.
Down a couple of scores. There's still time, all right? It's not like, you know, they're totally out of it, but they have to score quickly, and they're going to need some big-time plays, chunk plays, explosive plays. They need yardage on each snap.
And avoids the contact by sliding. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down. Well, there you go. Save your best scramble of the day for a big-time situation in the fourth quarter, picking up the first.
You don't want to use it up early, right? You want to make sure you save it for that exact moment, that key time. And that's what he did, although you and I both know it wasn't planned that way. But what a nice job using his eyes, scanning the field, and realizing when it was time to exit the pocket and go.
Screen play, McKinnon.
And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. Time for a break. We'll come back and see this one out after this. That pass play wound up for negative yardage, so here's second and 11. To throw, Garoppolo. And his throw here is incomplete. Nelson Agholor, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
Well, they're slinging it, and then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach, and incomplete. The Niners on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is third and 11.
Three down. Six.
Now Garoppolo. He's going to let it fly. And that is caught, one-handed. Oh, my, he pulled it in. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Of course, remember, you need a touchdown here and a field goal.
Doesn't matter the order, but they have to get it done and get it done fast.
Here we go. Hurry up. Look three.
Garoppolo to throw. Being chased out left. Hammering for the goal line. He loses the football. And this is recovered by the Cardinals.
Well, that drive wasn't a case of wanting to put points on the board. It was needing
they
to,
had it,
having
had it.
To, and they didn't get it done.
Yeah, didn't get it done, and now you look at the situation and the point differential, two scores, pretty much game, set, match.
How about the takeaway, though, huh? How about those defensive guys?
Watch it now, Barney!
Oh, Rosen's going to throw it. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. Past the 20. Touchdown, Cardinals. A big play there. 99 yards. And the Cardinals now adding on to their lead. Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Carlson now to kick this one away. This one fielded at the 5. So definitely good for the individual stats, maybe not for our storyline, but he's in for the late score. Now Hausch could attack on the extra point. Hauschka with the extra point, and the lead down to 10, 24-14. So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff. The Cardinal offense here ready to take over. They're in a good spot. Two-possession game, barely, but a two-possession game here late. Now they just have to put this game on ice.
Let's face it, right now, they're talking about ball security, taking care of it, not allowing anything crazy to happen, because we've seen nutty things happen down the stretch. But they also have the security of the scoreboard. With that type of a lead, even if something goes haywire, they're still in good shape.
Johnson, he's been busy this afternoon, and he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. This, in all probability, another run here on second and 8. On the ground, this is Johnson. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. And the 49ers going to take another timeout as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in the fourth. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
And the blitz does come. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
So possession goes over here on the punt. And San Francisco gets set to go here. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, two-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again. But they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly. Then they'll take it from there.
To throw is Garoppolo. Pressure comes and the Cardinals bring him down. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as the clock will stop with 33 seconds remaining. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Working from the gun, Garoppolo. His throw incomplete.
I want to go back to something you said in the first quarter
is
about
it,
winning.
Is it a positive?
It is a positive.
Okay.
About winning the turnover battle as a visiting team, as an underdog. You were right. They've done just that, and look where it's gotten them.
It's part of the formula. When you go on the road, as you mentioned, being an underdog, winning the turnover battle is a big key, and this one's playing out in this one.
Looking to throw, Garoppolo. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. This home crowd, they're happy with that call.
I like the way you said happy there, right? The so-called good guys didn't get a call. They feel like it's been that way all afternoon. You feeling their pain?
They finally got one.
Yes, they did.
Away to his left, and that is incomplete. 16 seconds now on the clock,
and that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that, first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Garoppolo looks to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. Incomplete. And we're down to 8 seconds now.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
The Niners on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third and 10.
Three down. 11.
And yet again, it's Garoppolo. He's going to let it fly. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Trey Boston.
Obviously disappointing, but you had to go for broke here, down 2 scores. So that forced you to make some throws you definitely wouldn't want to make. And I think this interception is going to pretty much write an end to this one.
Down to a knee. Here's the Cardinals look to let the clock roll.
A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you prime the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
So for the Cards, their battle to finish 500 gets a slight lift as they move to 6-8 on the year. And they will head home next week to take on the Seattle Seahawks. Meanwhile, for the 49ers,